نتوكل عليه. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا كثيرًا. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. وقال تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: صدق الله مولانا العظيم، وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. My dear respected honorable brothers, elders, mothers and sisters, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us in iman and taqwa. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to shower His endless blessings upon all of us and upon the entire ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma ameen. Dear brothers and sisters, I remind myself and my dear audience to be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah azza wa jal mentions in the Quran: Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullah haqqa tuqati. Be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a genuine consciousness, and do not die except in a state of submission. My dear brothers and sisters, we are all aware that each and every one of us have shortcomings. And last week we spoke about certain bad habits and how we can overcome those bad habits, bearing in mind that we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it such that we will make mistakes. In actual fact, in an authentic hadith, the Prophet of Allah said, لَوْ لَمْ تُذْنِبُوا لَذَهَبَ اللَّهُ بِكُمْ, that if you do not commit, make mistakes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would exchange us for another nation, and they will make mistakes and seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, in saying that, we all know that as believers, people that believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believe in our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we all agree that our lives will be much more better off without sin. And an example of this, subhanAllah, is the blessed month of Ramadan. When we fast, we ensure that we are conscious of Allah. And we are very careful about what we say and what we do, because we are avoiding sin as much as we can. We understand that it is a spiritual month. But I want to bring your attention to the feeling that you have. That beautiful feeling of not committing haram. There is a great sense of joy when you are pious and you draw nearer to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is a great feeling. But in today's khutbah, I want to speak about some of the consequences of the sins that we commit. Now bear in mind that there are two types of sins. The one sin are what we refer to as the saghair, the minor sins, which are washed away by doing good deeds, by performing wudu and ibadat, they wash away those sins. And then we have major sins. Major sins require tawbah, where we seek genuine forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of our great scholars, Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawzi, rahimahullah, mentions in great detail some of the outstanding consequences for me and you committing sin. And we need to be aware of that. Right? It is very, very important that we are aware of the consequences of our sins. Why is it important? When we understand the consequences, you know, when you have a child and you tell them, don't do this. Why? Because A, B, and C will happen to you. So likewise, as a believer, it is important that we understand the consequences of our sins with the main intention of avoiding sin at all costs, bi-idhnillah. And Ibn al-Qayyim mentions at the onset, subhanAllah, that it all began with our father, Adam alayhi salam, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Adam that you can do as you wish, but one thing do not do. وَلَا تَقْرَبَا هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةِ فَتَكُونَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ Don't come close to this tree, because if you do so, you will be amongst the wrongdoers. فَأَزَلَّهُمَا الشَّيْطَانُ عَنْهَا فَأَخْرَجَهُمَا مِمَّا كَانَا فِيهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, this was the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Adam alayhi salam, what did he do? He made a mistake. One mistake caused him to leave Jannah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave Adam. فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ When Adam alayhi salam made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah azza wa jal accepted his tawbah. And on the other hand, we have Iblis, who also made a big mistake. And what was that? Refusing to prostrate towards Adam alayhi salam. أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرْ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ Now what is the difference? They both made a sin, but look at the difference. Adam made a mistake based on desires. And he returned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah forgave him. There's a big difference. Whereas Iblis was arrogant. And as we know, the Prophet of Allah said, لَا تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ مَنْ كَانَ فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ مِنْ كِبْرٍ Will not enter Jannah a person who possesses an atom's weight of pride in their heart. SubhanAllah. It is so important that we avoid the quality of kibr. What is kibr? Al-kibru batarul haq wa ghamtun nas. Right? Arrogance is to conceal the truth and deceive people. SubhanAllah. And we learn from the nations that came in the past, from Nuh alayhi salam, because of them committing shirk, associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of their kufr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down upon them adab, punishments. The likes of Nuh alayhi salam, the entire community was washed out by a flood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informs us of huge tragedies and punishments that fell upon the people of Lut, the people of Hud, etc. And they were destroyed. Why? Because they waged war against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because they refused. They were arrogant. Again, we are brought back to the quality of arrogance. What? When the kuffar will be brought to the doors of Jahannam. And it will be said to them, وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ زُمَرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ Did we not send to you messengers يَتْلُونَ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِنَا Reciting the words of Allah upon you. Right? But they refused. And what will they say? قَالُوا بَلَى وَلَكِنْ حَقَّتْ كَلِمَةُ الْعَذَابِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ قِيلَ دُخُلُوا أَبْوَابَ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا What does Allah mention? فَبِئْسَ مَثْوَى الْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ How evil is their the abode of who? Mutakabbirin. A person who rejects the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are outright arrogant. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. My dear brothers and sisters, Ibn al-Qayyim mentions of the factors that really, the dangers and the consequences of committing sin is that we remove from our hearts the genuine love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are literally diminishing the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that when we commit sin, we know that this is against the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that should drive us having the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah says, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدَرِي. That we should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah azza wa jal deserves the best. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserves the best from me and from you. Point number two, of the consequences of committing sins, my brothers and sisters, is that committing sins will eat away at our iman. Slowly but surely, our iman will become weak. And if we look at the plot of shaitan, we all know that shaitan does not attack straight away. Ah, khutuwat. Shaitan works with small steps. And that's why Allah says, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Do not follow the footsteps of shaitan. When a person commits sin, they have actually forgotten about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a person commits sin, they are slowly, slowly chipping away the tree of iman. And each of every one of us, and we've spoken about the tree of iman, shajaratul iman, every time we commit a sin, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that shaitan places a dot on the heart. Another major sin, another dot, another dot, another dot. And when there is no repentance, what happens? The heart becomes rusty. And then we start justifying disobeying the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We start justifying doing haram. And then we come to a stage where doing haram is normal. Have you seen such people? They do haram. There is no conscience anymore. Why? Because the heart is so polluted. And the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that a person will come to a stage where they don't make any repentance or good deeds. Their heart becomes so rusted. And the Prophet of Allah gave the example of a muddy river. A person goes to the desert and they see a very dirty, murky river. That will be the state of your heart. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَلَّا بَلْ رَانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Their hearts, rather, their hearts have become rusted. Why? Because of their bad deeds. Because of their bad deeds. And we don't realize, subhanallah, that when we commit these major sins or these addictions that we have, it is eating at our souls slowly, slowly, slowly. And subhanallah, my brothers and sisters, imagine if we were to die committing these sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Allahumma ameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, of the consequences of committing sin, is that it draws us away from the purpose of why Allah Azza wa Jal created us. Allah says, وَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. If we understand this purpose, we understand that ita'ah of Allah Azza wa Jal, obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is my priority. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ. Do not be amongst those who forget Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that those who forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have actually forgotten themselves. My brothers and sisters, in reality, sin is so dangerous because the ultimate goal of sin is to allow the believer to end up in kufr. Remember that? Have you heard the story of Barsisa? I'm sure we all know the story of Barsisa. From a person being so righteous And then slowly, 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 to the last moment, كَمَثَلِ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ قَرِيبًا ذَاقُوا وَبَالَ أَمْرِهِمْ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ كَمَثَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ إِذْ قَالَ لِلْإِنسَانِ اكْفُرْ فَلَمَّا كَفَرَ قَالَ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّنْكَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ This is the plot of Shaitan, to bring you to the last moment, to that point where you renounce Islam. And that's the reality. When we drift further and further and further, the plot of the devil is what? For you to leave Islam. If you do that, you're successful. SubhanAllah. So remember, the consequences of your sin is that it can lead to kufr. It can lead to a person leaving the fold of Islam. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through His mercy, informs us that whenever we commit sin, subhanAllah, the believer, it is done under the influence of jahala, of ignorance. Allah says, إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ بِجَهَالَةٍ The scholars of tafsir mention that every sin that is committed by a believer, even if it's intentional, it is done under the basis of ignorance. Allahu Akbar. Look at the mercy of Allah. Why? Because if your heart was to really understand the greatness of Allah, the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we would not sin. May Allah forgive us all. My brothers and sisters, of the consequences of committing sin, is that sin, it removes haya. It removes haya. And the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَفْعَلْ مَا شِئْتَ If you don't have modesty, then do whatever your heart desires. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that every religion has a certain khuluq. It has a certain characteristic. And the characteristic of Islam is haya. Al-haya'u min al-iman. As the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, being modest, being shameful, it is part of Islam. We know, even subhanAllah, the believer, we ensure that when we are at home, when we go to the bathroom or we go have a shower, we ensure that after we have made our ghusl, immediately we cover ourselves up, we dry ourselves and we put our clothing on as soon as possible. Why? Out of respect for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is haya. This is our modesty. We love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much, even behind doors where no one can see us, we try our best to be modest at all costs. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. My brothers and sisters, of the consequences of sin is that sin in reality brings about depression. When a person constantly is involved in major sin and haram, eventually they will be depressed. Allah says, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ The one who turns away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will be granted a life of anxiety, a life of stress and depression. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us all. Of the consequences of sins, my brothers and sisters, is that when a huge society commits sin, this will draw the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is no doubt that as believers, we believe that every calamity that comes about, there is a great possibility that it has happened due to the sin of man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ That corruption has been spread on the earth. Why? Due to what man has earned with his own hands. We look at the pandemic that has taken place. This is all from the sin of people, subhanAllah. Haya is thrown out the door. People are dressed the way they want to, right? People are waging war against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We see now things that go against the family unit, that destroy the concept of the family, waging war directly against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This will bring about the adab, the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as this is established in the Quran and the Sunnah of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the last point of the consequences of sins is that when we continue persisting on sins, my brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take away blessings from us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove blessings from our life. Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Under the tafsir of this ayah was revealed regarding certain people who commit sin, and because of them committing sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed blessings from their lives. So what should we do, subhanAllah? There are four things that we should avoid at all costs. Number one, we will make mistakes. And when we make mistakes, we will seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that will continue until the day we die. But these are four things that are non-negotiable that we should never indulge in whatsoever. Point number one, never commit a sin publicly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive a person who commits or broadcasts their sin in the open. Hadith, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Allah shall forgive all sins except the one who commits fahisha publicly. May Allah protect us all. Number two, never stop seeking forgiveness from Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Allah will not punish them for as long as they are constantly seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Point number three, never be arrogant with regards to your sin. A person who says, Allah won't forgive me, that's arrogance. Because why? You are humiliating your Creator, because Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim. So never be arrogant. Don't be arrogant at all, in any way possible. Don't be arrogant, full stop. And of course, at the end, our goal is to try and come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never give up battling those sins. And always remember these repercussions, inshallah, so that it motivates us to, inshallah, stay away. And remember, you commit sin, ensure that you follow that up by doing even more good, bi-idhnillah. And inshallah, the day will come that you will break that cycle and you will draw nearer to the mercy of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never lose hope. Always stay positive, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Barakallahu lana wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim. Wa nafa'ana wa iyaakum bil-ayati wa dhikri al-hakim. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'iri al-muslimin fa astaghfiru innahu huwa al-ghafur rahim. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا كثيرًا. أما بعد، فيا معشر الإخوان، اتقوا ربكم واخشوا يومًا لا يجزي والد عن ولده ولا مولود هو جاز عن والده شيئًا. إن وعد الله حق، فلا تغرنكم الحياة الدنيا ولا يغرنكم بالله الغرور. واعلموا أن الله تعالى أمركم بالصلاة والسلام على حبيبه المصطفى، حيث يقول جل وعلا، إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل محمد، كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم القرابة والصحابة والتابعين وتبع التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب من يحبك والعمل الذي يقربنا إلى حبك. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك واقلنا بفضلك عمن سواك. اللهم إنك عفو كريم رحيم تحب العفو فاعف عنا يا كريم. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق وأعمالنا من الرياء وألسنتنا من الكذب وأعيننا من الخيانة، فإنك تعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. يا أرحم الراحمين، يا ذا القوة المتين، يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. يا حي يا قيوم، برحمتك نستغيث، أصلح لنا شأننا كله، ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين. اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب من يحبك والعمل الذي يقربنا إلى حبك. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك، واغننا بفضلك عن من سواك. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار، وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار، يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. عباد الله، رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروني ولا تكفرون. وأقم الصلاة. ربنا الله، إن الله يأمر